Yo guys, this is Alex here again, and today I'm going to show you how to make one more toy from Smurfs, and that is Papa Smurf, as you can see from red color here, and of course from title. So how to make Papa Smurf? We will start with head, because head is most difficult part of the toy, so better to make that first. And the rest of the toy is almost completely the same as on Brainy, only difference is color of pants, and that's it. So here this difference. What you need to do? We will make head with 164 size of pieces, so almost whole toy is 164, and you need to make base of 4 pieces per row like this, and then you need to increase to 8. So you need to start like this, put white piece, of course base is made with blue pieces, but you need to put in second row one white piece, because we start with beard from second row. And now we need to increase like this, so put one white piece on side, and on side of that white piece, and put two white pieces on top. And do the same thing on the other side. Like this. Now we will increase this rest, but with blue pieces. So blue piece between, and then two blue pieces on top. Like this. And now we continue with increasing. So you need to put, let's first increase between these white pieces. So white piece on top. And white piece between, and two white pieces on top. And here we will increase with blue piece on side of that white piece, but on beard part we will put white piece on top, and on other part we will put blue piece on top, and do the same thing on this side. Here white piece, and blue piece here. Like this, and now increase between other pieces. So it should look something like this. And now what you need to do. And now you need to put white piece on top of blue and white. And do the same thing on the other side. And then continue with white pieces. But we need to put mouth here. So we will put three blue pieces in the middle. And then just put side here, white pieces. This you can squeeze a little bit. And you can finish this row with blue pieces. And now what you need to do. Now take one blue piece and put in vertically on top of white and blue on side, on both sides, like this, and then finish this back part with normal blue pieces. So normal blue pieces. And this one is inverted. Like this. And here you need to put white pieces on top, normal white pieces. Like this. And now what you need to do? You need to put on top of these white pieces. First, let's put this middle piece like this. And then you need to put two more on side, on each side, two more. So five blue pieces. We start with face now, part where eyes and nose goes. And now you need to put four on top. That, and now you put five on top. I put like this, put this piece on top of this first as well, both sides like this, and then we will do the same thing for beard part. So first put white piece like this and another one, and then one in the middle and two on top, like this. Now let's finish on this side. Like this. And now what you need to do. Now you need to put four blue pieces on top of these five. Still making this face part. Like this. And now you need to fill this back part with blue pieces, normal blue pieces. Just three rows, it's not anything complicated. And now here where you don't have piece, just put on blue one, same thing as you did here for face. Squeeze a little bit, and now we need to put red pieces for head. And you see here, when I put red piece to connect this white part here and blue part, it's the same row where we put these four pieces. So because we will make head like this, it looks like this, but it's better to put like this. Don't put straight line around because of eyebrows and eyes, because you cannot put them well. So just finish this row that we started with blue parts, I mean pieces. Finish with red. Like this. And now put on top two more rows of red pieces. It's not so easy. But I think it's much more easier for you to make now than for me to design this. So let's put one more row. That is completely the same as on brain. Because all Smurfs here have, almost all Smurfs have same designs of clothes and hats. Like this. Now you can push this a little bit down, this front part here. You can squeeze a little bit, and here at the back part you need to find back part. So we first need to find middle, somewhere here, put at the back part six. Same thing, six red pieces. Six red pieces, and then put on top. Five. Find somewhere in the middle. Don't need to be exact middle, but somewhere at the back part. As you can see, because it goes like this, you know how it goes. And now let's see what we need to make. First of all, you need to make eyes. Something like this you can make with paper and color. And for ears, simple thing. For ears from 132 size of piece, you need to make leg two times, and then here where we have this part, you see, perfect place for ears. Put them a little bit down like this. Put on both sides like this. And for nose, we make a little bit smaller nose because of eyes and eyebrows, so we can fit everything. So one is, it's the same size of pieces. For brainy, 1/16 size of piece, you open piece, you bend like this. So how much, when you see here this line, so just over that line, and then you have this extra part, so just bend inside again and then close, and then when you close you just push a little bit to make nose. And now you can put nose. You see this middle blue piece, so above that piece you need to put nose. If you cannot put nose, you need to take scissors and make hole a little bit bigger. And then nose inside. Or you can raise this a little bit So that's the nose, like this. You will glue eyes here. I cannot show you exactly the same spot somewhere here, as you can see. Maybe let's test how it works better. Close to the nose. Something like this. And then you need to cut with white paper eyebrows. I mean, cut with scissors, don't cut with paper. I don't know if that is possible. So, eyebrows like this. And then final part. Just a sec. This is final part for top. So you need to make with 132. 1-2 formation, so go 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. So start with 1, finish with 2. And that's the top part. So you need to insert that part inside of this hole and bend down and glue on head. So as you can see, something like this. Then you can push these back pieces on top. So it should look like this. And I recommend to glue eyes and eyebrows before you put this part, because it will be difficult for you to balance eyebrows in best position when you have this on top. So now I will glue that part and show you how it looks when you glue everything together for head. So guys, when you glue these pieces together, parts together, it should look something like this. As you can see here. So, that's the head. Now guys, let's make body, arms and legs. It's very simple and easy. This is leg, same thing as on brainy. And for hand like this, this is right hand. Difference will be thumb, because on left one you will put here. How to make that? Very easy. You need to take 5 blue pieces, 164, and you need to open them a little bit like this. Make them bigger. See. And do the same thing in total 5 times. You make something like this. It's a little bit wider, so it's better. But if we want to put bigger pieces, it won't look good, so it's better to open smaller pieces and make this. And if we put two one formation, it will be wider than we need. So one more wider piece like this. So this hand, glue all these pieces, and take 2 pieces and you need to insert them here in each hole, this bottom piece, put one piece like this. And now let's make fingers. So how to make finger? Take one piece, open while I fold this back part, and then try to open a little bit this to make something like this. And you need to make four fingers. Let's make all four. And put like this in the middle, in vertically, put one finger. Put on side one and one more on this side. So don't push them all the way in, something like this. And then you need to put this one in, but put normally or vertically. Let me see a second. Okay, let's put normally here in this bottom piece. That's the white piece that we make white. So normally for thumb like this. And that's it. That's the hand. It's the left one. We have two hands now. And now four legs. You need to make one stick of three for top part, same thing white pieces, and for feet part or shoe part we will go to one formation. Make wider, and then you need to take one red piece while I fold back, put inside here in vertically. I mean, he's normally, but these top pieces are in vertically, so it's in vertically when you compare to top part of the leg. Just put inside, and then you need to slide between these pieces. That's it. When you glue, it should look something like this. So that's the legs. Now we need to make body part. So how to make body part? You need to start with bottom part, pants, and you need to make base of four pieces per row, 164 size, and then you need to increase to 8. So put one red piece between two pieces, and then put two red pieces on top. And then you need to do the same thing between other pieces. This between, and then two on top. And then do the same thing two more times. So we're increasing to 8. And that will be end of increasing, because we don't need any more. And now put one more row of red pieces. Like this. That's pretty much it for pants part. Now we need to make upper body part. So we need blue pieces, and you need to put three rows of blue pieces on top. And now guys, let's put one more row of blue pieces on top. I thought it's three, but it's four. So let's put very fast one more row. Nice. And now what you need to do. For tail, you will take one piece, 164, and then make leg like this. I mean, leg is tail, leg shape, and put in at the back part, somewhere in the middle, below this top row, because this first row is almost flat surface down, so you can put here. So when you finish this, what you need to do? For hand, you will take one blue piece, 164, while you fold back, insert in hand here on top, and then put between this last row like this. Or maybe more. The back part depends where you put this tail, so maybe here, like this. So the other hand will be here. And for leg, you will just put some glue on top here, and then push maybe this top, you will put in this hole. And the other one in this middle hole. And then push inside and put one next to each other, and that's it. I will show you how it looks when you glue that. And I will put one accessory on him. So some kind of bag that he holds. Maybe it's too long, this. I will maybe cut and make smaller, I don't know. Maybe it is, but maybe it's not. We'll see. So I'll put that because I already made, so I need to put and then glue head on top. Something like this. You don't need to make this accessory, but I like to put some accessory on toys, so on all toys. So you can make this with cardboard or paper. It's nothing special, very simple to make. As you can see, that's it. So this head, of course, you already saw, just need to push here, put some glue here, put some glue here, and then put like this and glue, and that's Papa Smurf. So let's finish everything and connect everything, and I'll show you how it looks when you finish with gluing. So guys, when you finish with gluing and connecting and everything, it should look something like this. Completely finished. I resized this belt for bag because it was too big, so now it's perfect. So if you want to make some bag, you can put somewhere around hand here. So that long. Don't put too much down. And when you glue everything, it should look like this. Legs, back part, and head. And of course you can put bag when you finish everything. You don't need to put like I did, because I already made. So that's it, guys. If you like this model, you can like this video and share this video, of course, and comment. And if you want to compare to Brainy, almost same size, this. And if you show support for this video and this model, of course, more Smurf or Smurfs, I don't know, coming soon. So that's it, guys. Take care. Thanks for watching, and I see you soon. Bye.